If we could save on our power bills, we could maybe afford to get our hair done more often. But as it is an expense, many of us try to do a home dyeing job, which can end, let's be honest, quite badly. So to help us save on a bad hair day, Trudy has rules for dyeing your hair at home. Welcome, Trudy.
Hi, Mel.
So I've had some nightmares with this in the past. I've ended up with orange hair, all sorts of things. Yeah. How do you choose the right shade?
I think don't get too clever. My rule is to only go either two shades lighter or two shades darker and leave the clever stuff, like the balayage and the highlights and the complete colour change, to a stylist.
Yeah, go and see a professional for that.
Yeah.
So how do you avoid making a mess?
I think most people go, oh, my hair looks terrible, I better colour it, and they're going out in 20 minutes. So make time, put time aside, you need at least an hour, cover the bathroom floor in a black plastic bag because you slosh it around, cape yourself up, section your hair off into four sections, and have a back mirror, or get your husband to learn how to do the back of your hair on YouTube, because there's heaps of videos on
it. I bet there is. Husband's doing the back of the hair.
But yeah, I think the big thing is just make sure you've got time. Set aside some time.
Okay, it's not going to be a really quick, instant
job.
So do you need to consider the length of the cut or the style before you do the colouring?
I think most people make a mistake when they go and buy a colour and they buy one pack and they've got really thick, really long hair and they run out halfway through and it looks patchy, the end result. So a good rule is if your hair is past your shoulders, you need two packs of colour. You can't get away with one.
That is really good to know.
And if your hair is very thick, the same goes. Sometimes three. If you've got very thick, long hair, mix it up. You're better to throw colour out than you end up with a patchy result.
Absolutely, that's for sure. What about staining the skin? How do you avoid getting like it all over you and all over your face?
Rub a little bit of Vaseline around the hairline, or lip balm if you don't have any Vaseline. It just acts as a little barrier for it to drip forward. Also, one tip is that colour removes colour. So if you've got stain on your face or any of your fingers, get some of the colour and rub it in, and it actually, the pigment pulls the colour off your skin. Yeah, and when you actually take your colour off, don't shampoo your colour out, because shampoos generally contain sulfates and they help lift the colour, because your hair cuticle is open once it's been coloured.
Right.
So you want to actually keep that colour in. So just rinse it out and use the conditioner that's
Those are some really good tips. And what about applying the colour? Do you have any tips there?
I think take your time and section it off. If you section your hair into a cross, like a hot cross bun, and then take small sections, get a friend over, maybe have the wine after you've done the colour, and get them to learn how to do the back. It's really easy to just to pull sections in small sections. Big sections don't work. You end up with patchy results. So small sections, section the hair off, clip it back. Or just touch up the hairline. You know, that's what people see. They don't often see the back of your hair. Just touch up the hairline and then go back to your stylist, you know, every few months.
Okay, so you bought some products in today.
I bought some things in today.
Let's start with this one.
Okay, can we start this end? Because is a permanent...
Yes,
sorry,
Trudy,
I'm
you're
bossy.
The boss. Yeah.
So my hairdresser, MYHD, this is a Australian company who have been making salon colour forever, but it's available in the pharmacy. Amazing. I actually use it to touch up my roots. It's so good. So home colour, but it actually performs like salon colour.
Wow.
The other thing I wanted to quickly mention is that colour is graded from a 10 to a 1, 10 being blonde, 1 being black. So that's a good guide to follow.
Okay.
The next one is talking about hair. You know, you often look at it and think it looks dull. Schwarzkopf make a great toner, a radiance gloss toner that you can put through blonde hair to tone, which actually saves you, you know, maybe if you're going to salon just to get your hair toned, you could do that at home and you're not going to make mistakes.
Like a super strength, like using a purple shampoo, but a bit more.
Yeah, it gets rid of that brassiness.
Oh,
and
good.
They've got colours for brunettes as well. And New, I wanted to share a little app with you too, which is so clever. New is Clairol. They do an amazing root touch-up, but they also do this new colour, which is launching on Monday, Colour Crave. So if you wanted to sort of party, like I know you do like to, but in the ends, a bit of pink or a little purple, and it washes out after about 16 shampoos.
That's great. And finally?
And also new from Clairol, which I love their root touch-up, so I bought this in. This is also launching on Monday, is a great instant colour that you can spray on the roots to hide that regrowth. So if you're not brave enough to colour your hair at home, there are options.
Excellent. Everyone needs to know that one.
$13 at the supermarket. So,
perfect.
Yeah.
Hey, Trudy, thank you so much.
Absolute pleasure.
Always in with good intel. And for more beauty know-how from Trudy, you can head to her website, beautyeq.co.nz.